The Prime Minister is trying to quell a power struggle with the states over a plan to lower energy bills. Pressure is on the federal government to reveal its next move as the Christmas deadline draws closer.
Showing some love to South Australian towns on the flood front line.
And if you do come, come stay with us.
His biggest problem is soaring power prices are here to stay. The Prime Minister treading a difficult path as he works on a solution.
Clearly, there are limits on what the Commonwealth can do by itself.
And there are limits on how much the states want to pitch in.
It's my expectation that South Australians won't be punished because we've done the right thing and led the effort around transition.
A push for a price cap to make coal-fired power cheaper has New South Wales and Queensland pushing for compensation over lost revenue.
The federal government is working these issues through cooperatively with state and territories.
A price cap on gas could also form part of a major package of energy interventions to be discussed by National Cabinet on Wednesday and unveiled before Christmas.
What we're aimed clearly at doing is at putting downward pressure on prices for both businesses and also for households.
Because the cost of not acting would be much higher.
For businesses who are exposed to these prices, this gets very nasty indeed, and some businesses may struggle to hang on.
This is a global phenomenon that is occurring as a result of the Russian invasion of Ukraine.
To starve President Putin of funding for his war, Australia Today joined a new multinational effort to impose a price cap on Russian oil, stopping major economies paying more than $60 a barrel, a move softened by Moscow's plan to increase exports to China and India. Eliza Edwards, Nine News.